thought I'd show you something today. I was looking at a whole bunch of code as I was making this demo for ClipPath and ShapePath Editor in Firefox. I rediscovered a funny thing about CSS Grid, and I tweeted about it really quickly, and people were interested in it. So I thought, oh, let me make a video about this. So let's come over here. I've got this example in CodePen. I'll put the link to this in the description for this video, and you can click on it and check it out yourself. And I've got here a main element with an H1, a bunch of paragraphs, pretty simple HTML. And then I've got very simple CSS. So there's a little bit of like reset in typography, but mostly for a layout, I've got these two lines of CSS. I've got a margin moving the main element away from the outer edge by using a margin on the body element. And then I put on the main itself display grid. And just this one line of code does something very interesting. So let's come over and look at this same example without all that code penness all over it, just the example by itself on this page. And we can see here, this is the HTML. I'm here in Firefox Nightly actually, looking at the Firefox grid inspector down here, CSS inspect CSS here. We can see here's our main element, and we've got a grid, display grid on it, which turns this main into a grid container, and each of the children. So the H1 is the first child. It becomes the first item, the first grid item placed on this particular grid. Here, let's turn on the grid. We can click on this little icon of a grid next to where it says display grid, and this shows us the lines for the grid in the Firefox Grid Inspector. So we can see here that the H1 is in the first cell, the P is in the second cell, the next B, the next paragraph is in the third cell, the next paragraph is in the fourth cell, and so on. And you can see here that each of these are actually quite far apart from each other. Let's turn off the grid. You can see all that sort of space between those paragraphs, more than maybe we're used to seeing. If we turn off display grid, you can see that suddenly, boom, all the paragraphs are closer to each other. And when we hover over these paragraphs, we can see here, for example, the second paragraph, the content box is highlighted in blue. That's the actual content of this paragraph. And then the margins for the paragraph are highlighted in yellow. So we can see that, oh, it's not even specified. So we're inheriting from the browser style sheet, the styles that automatically come with the browser. We're inheriting a top and bottom margin of, I think it's 1M on paragraphs. And you can see that here, the second paragraph and the third paragraph, there's a bottom margin on the second paragraph, there's a top margin on the third paragraph. Both of those are 1M, and they are physically in the same space. It doesn't add up to 2M total. It's like 1M overlapped for both of those paragraphs together. This is called margin collapsing, and this is a thing that CSS has had since the very, very, very beginning of CSS. It's how margins work in a lot of situations, but it doesn't always work that way. Sometimes they don't collapse. If you have a new block formatting context, for example, then you don't have margins collapsing, and if you don't have a new block formatting context, you do have margins collapsing, and that can get very confusing because many of us, probably most of us, don't even know what a block formatting context is or what any of that stuff means. If you want to dig further into it, you can look here on MDN Web Docs. There's a whole page on mastering margin collapsing. You can go look up block formatting context, you can go look up display flow route and some other stuff. But without getting into those weeds, let's just look here and see that, in fact, without display grid, we really don't have any layout specified in our CSS at all, and we get a flow layout. This is just a typical flow layout. Everything is the width of its containing block, and we've just got stuff on the page with margins collapsing. But if we turn display grid back on, the margins stop collapsing, so that second paragraph and the third paragraph, the margins are stacked on top of each other. They're not in the same space. They both count. So we've got a total of 2M of margin between those paragraphs. Why is that happening? Well, that's happening because of the way that grid works. So here, let's turn on the grid inspector lines again, and we can see here that we've got this content box and we've got those two margins, and the grid cell is in fact the height of the content box plus the margins, which is also known as the margin box. The grid cell contains the entire margin box. Each one of these grid items is wholly contained inside of its grid cell, which has the effect of getting rid of margin collapsing. which is fascinating. There's been a debate probably since the day margin collapsing was invented or before it was even decided whether or not it would go into CSS. There's been this debate about whether or not this is a good idea. In fact, I was at this conference last year, CSS Day in Amsterdam. Bert Boss, Hakam Lee were there having this conversation. These are the two men who wrote the original CSS 1 specification and are considered the inventors of CSS. Hakam Lee is considered the father of CSS. And they were debating on stage ideas that went into CSS and whether or not they were a good idea. And one of the ones they talked about was margin collapsing. Was that a good idea? We're probably still debating it. But meanwhile, if you sort of want to live in a world without any margin collapsing, you can throw CSS Grid at stuff and make the margin collapsing go away. I think that's fascinating. That's just sort of one example of thousands of things that we will discover as we really begin to dig into our new tools, our new reality, using CSS Grid, all the things that add up to what I'm calling intrinsic web design. Maybe you'll find this fun. If so, comment below. Tell me what you think of margin collapsing and how you might possibly use this in the future. So hopefully this video helps get that started.